thankfully. I don't think they're really who they claim to be. Been in LA, think you're jading me. Didn't call you, that was the fate in me. Oh, whoa. On the edge of the map, then I drop. Keep a watch, demons pop up, open shop. Walk the walls like I'm SWAT, could you not? Still a pot, Goldie lock, got my spot. LA Bob, she got face, but no thoughts, yeah. Like a church with no God, just a box, yeah. What's your purpose? Yeah. And we taking what you got, yeah. You live in a glass house. Careful when we rock, yeah. Do it faithfully. I don't think they're really who they claim to be. Been in LA, think you're jading me. Didn't call you, that was the fate in me, oh. And when they came through,
thank you for tuning in to Darth News, where we drop the comedy and pick up the news, god damn it. Welcome to Darth News, where we slap the meat and step in the bullshit. Thank you for tuning in to Darth News, where we turn fiction into reality. We turn non-fiction into reality. Shit! Welcome to Darth News, where we put down our morals and pick up the prostitutes. Welcome to Darth News, where we say no to drugs and yes to gay people. It looks like Robert Downey Jr. has just shot his own career right in the dick. Or the horse, the elephant, a zebra, right in the, Robert Downey Jr. just shot his career in the Doolittle. Dick, he just blew off his dick and balls, basically. Now, Robert Downey Jr. still has a career, okay? He's gonna be just he's gonna be just fine. His career will be A-O-K, I can't even do the okay sign. It's bullshit. But RDJ will be just fine. But my question is, what idiot thought that this would be a good career move for Robert Downey Jr.? He needs to fire his agent, like yesterday. I mean, Downey is coming off of the biggest movie of all time. And not just movie, like the biggest franchise, cinematic of extravaganza thing, you know what I mean? The biggest of all time. And his agent thinks that he should talk to fucking animals and pull trombones out of dragons' assholes? Well, it looks like Robert Downey Jr.'s misstep is gonna cost him about $100 million. Not him, but the studio. $100 million. Let's read the article. This article is written by Kevin Berwick. He's kind of like the go-to guy, I guess, for these articles. Robert Downey Jr.'s Doolittle could lose $100 million at the box office. The movie is already the first bomb of 2020. Hey, what about? Not the first bomb. What about this movie, you know? You know what I'm talking about. Cats. Was that technically in 2020 or 2019? I don't know. The movie sucked and it bombed. I think Cats bombed so bad it lost like $175 million. So that's like $75 million worse than this movie. The movie's already the first bomb of 2020, yada yada yada, and things could get even more bleak for the family movie in the coming months ahead. The project is Robert Downey Jr.'s first outside the Marvel Cinematic Universe since last year's Avengers Endgame, and hopes were initially high. However, terrible reviews from both critics and viewers have now taken its toll. As of writing this, the movie has earned just $29.5 million domestically from its national debut holiday weekend. Globally, Doolittle has made now $56.8 million, which is not all that bad. It was number 3 in the North American box office over the weekend, just behind 1917 and Bad Boys for Life. But the movie is still projected to lose $100 million when it's all said and done. Mainly because the massive $178 million price tag. Wow. Who Who greenlit this shit? Who thought it was a good idea to let someone borrow $180 million plus whatever marketing about a guy who talks to animals? This is that's what you get. The initial production cost does not factor into the promotional aspect either, which has to be a hefty sum. Yeah, I'm sure the promotional aspect has to be a hefty sum. Usually the promotional aspect is about double. So the marketing is usually equal to the production budget initially. So it's, so if we're talking, I mean, this could be a huge loss for the studio. On paper, Doolittle seemed like a slam dunk, but there were some troubles behind the scenes. Apparently, the studio did not think that the original version of the movie was family-friendly enough. So there were reshoots that were ordered. It is believed that some of the more bonker scenes, including the constipated dragon, were added during these reshoots in an effort to make it more kid-friendly and less serious. Kids' movies can be serious. They can have... According to the reviews, the reshoot moments stick out like a sore thumb and are mainly to blame for all of the negativity surrounding the movie at this point in time. Yeah, reshoots usually fuck movies. But Robert Downey Jr., I don't know what you were thinking, dude. What were you thinking, man? Your accent was terrible. It was terrible. I can't even do it. It's so bad. I love you, Tony, but this was a bad idea. Bad choice. Just sweep this under the rug and forget about it. No wonder they dumped Doolittle in January. Why didn't they just go with the Eddie Murphy route? You know, the formula that proven to work? That it was like a $20 million budget? Basically, $20 million went to Eddie Murphy and the rest was pro bono? And it was about a vet that could talk to animals. That's it. Boom. No need for this crazy adventure talking to dragons and pulling shit out of dragons' assholes. None of that. You don't need that. Apparently, Robert Downey Jr. is still out promoting Doolittle, but that job might just be cut short thanks to the terrible reviews and poor box office performance. Yeah, you know, just find, you see, Robert Downey Jr., he needs to find his niche. He needs to find something new. And it's not Doolittle, okay? Iron Man is dead. We're moving on. But you gotta find something new. I don't know. It doesn't have to be a trilogy or sequels. Just find a new creative outlet that's not talking to animals. Okay? But anyway, in case you're confused as to the change from upstairs to downstairs, I deleted half of this video by accident, so I have to reshoot it, which I just did. So that's why. That's why. It's fuck you.